FM News. On point.
Look at the news, I'm Lynn Komjisha. Hearing of the Matthew Kanyamunyu murder case today has suffered another blow as defense lawyers made no show in court, prompting trial judge to advise Kanyamunyu to hire other lawyers or consider state lawyers. This after Kanyamunyu informed court that for 10 days now he's not been able to talk to his lawyers, including Mark Dusman, Kabega, Kale Balaka and Evans Ocheng, as they have all refused to pick his calls. He said he only received a message from one of his lawyers as he was coming to court this morning, informing him that he won't be present in court. Trial judge Stephen Obidu has advised Kanyamunyu to try and get in touch with his lawyers today or inform the court registrar of the new lawyers before the case comes up for hearing Monday next week. Kanyamunyu's case, in which he is jointly charged with his girlfriend Cynthia Mnyangwari for shooting dead social worker Kenneth Akena, was coming up for the defense team to cross-examine the investigating officer, but it has now been adjourned to Monday next week. KCCA Council has approved the new Kampala District Land Board, composed of 7 members. The board is chaired by Balondemu David, with other members who include Christian Chayune, Anguria Joseph, Kamoga Moses, Kato Hussein, Tepistan Tale Sek Chito, and Nasa Basaja Balaba. The chairman of the board, David Balondemu, has pledged transparency as they execute their duties.
I also want to thank the councillors, through Mr. Speaker, for accepting me as the chairman of the board. I pledge to offer leadership that will be transparent and accountable to the authority. I will work in harmony with all the members of the board. I'll also work in harmony with all the departments of the authority and all sister agencies to ensure that we deliver service.
A group of youth this morning took to the streets of Hoima demanding that Bunyoro Kitala Kingdom breaks the silence and saves Bugoma Forest. Led by Ismail Mugabe, the youth said they are disappointed with the Kingdom of Bunyoro because it has remained silent on this sensitive issue. Mugabe said Bugoma Forest must be saved at whatever cost, regardless of whether the forest belongs to National Forestry Authority or Bunyoro Kingdom. Ronnie Mugasa, one of the youth who participated in the demo, said that the Prime Minister of Bunyoro Kingdom, Andrew Byakutaga, must make an effort to save Bugoma Forest instead of claiming that he was not in office at the time the transaction took place. The youth threatened to lead a campaign to boycott Hoima Sugar if they continue with their plans to destroy Bugoma Forest for sugarcane growing.
Our daughters also must see the Bugoma Forest Hero, Huzara Bana, to go on the night where Jeva Sanga, Kibirekio, Yakutaga, or Inabai Chukuru, and every kingdom of Fisher Yabivayim. Abandu, we are going to expose you very soon and how much you got and how it came on your account. So, Hoima Sugar, we are coming to you. I call upon all Abana Bona Babunyo, Abatu Bona Babunyo, Murugeyo, Turuanire Kosenu, and the week you're not to be dedicating. We are fighting for Bugoma Forest.
Efforts to get a comment from Byakutaga were futile as he could not be reached in his office or on mobile. In other news, Joe Biden has edged ahead of Donald Trump in Georgia by about 900 ballots with only a few thousand votes left to count. With the 16 electoral votes winning the state, it would put Biden just one shy of the crucial 270 threshold needed to win the presidency. It would also deny Donald Trump a straight victory, even if he won all the remaining states, which, as it stands, looks unlikely. He would only be able to take 269 electoral college votes, leaving the candidates in an unprecedented draw. Taking Georgia would be a momentous shift. Since 1964, the Peach State has only voted for a Democratic presidential candidate 4 times, the last time for Bill Clinton in 1992. It has opted for Biden this year, and it would be an island of blue in a sea of red on the electoral map surrounded by Republican states. Many online are giving credit for the potential shift to Stacey Abrams. The Democrat ran for governor in 2018, and while she lost, she has spent the intervening 2 years campaigning there for her party. That was the news.
XFM News. On point.